Have you ever noticed yourself when you were swimming in water that your legs were never still? Rather, they were always paddling in water along with the movements of the hands. They were always on the move so that we could stand in water or we could swim so that we would not get drowned. That is called to be always on the move or on the journey. To be always on the move is to make sure of something has lively been sought. St. Peter Julian Eymond, the Apostle of the Eucharist, the founder of the Congregation of the Blessed Sacrament, once described himself as a little like Jacob, always on a journey, always seeking in truth. It was there from the beginning, the great love and the driving passion of his life, Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. The important quality of being always on the move or journey is to seek or search for the greater treasure in one's life. St. Peter Julian Eymond started his life journey in search for the treasure in his life, which is Eucharist alone, by which he was so attracted from the very childhood that he could not sit quietly without making efforts to attain this gift of his life. He was like the man in Matthew Gospel who was in search of fine pearl, and once he found, he went out and sold everything to buy that fine pearl, and he bought it. St. Peter Julian Eymond had a similar experience of seeking the Lord in his sacrament, and to receive, he had to make so many sacrifices, even at the age of 12, sacrificing food, leading very pious life, and be available to the celebration of the Eucharist. There were some goodly pearls that are set before him, but the chief of all pearls and very costly pearl among all, he found only the Eucharist, and he received it joyfully for the first time in his first Holy Communion, and from then onwards he continued till his death. He was always on his journey of making Eucharist as part of his life because he found it as a treasure hidden in human life. As we know, St. Peter Julian Eymond searched for an answer for indifference of his time and the religious ignorance. He found it in the love of God manifested in the Eucharist. Captivated by this desire, he was fully on foot, walking, running, discovering, sacrificing, and etc. to get the treasure. He left everything for the sake of Jesus, Jesus in the Eucharist. On his journey, he never ignored any of the God experience, be it for a short time like Thanksgiving prayer after communion in the Eucharist, or be it for a long time like carrying the Blessed Sacrament during the Corpus Christi. He made use of all experiences as food on the way to continue his journey like Jacob in times past. Priesthood was the important key to take possession of the Eucharist, so he decided to become a priest no matter whatever the crosses, restrictions, sicknesses and failures were on the way as obstacles. He was constantly feeding his life with the fire of the Holy Spirit to live for the Eucharistic Lord. He has taken fire, which is a life, always an example to explain about the Eucharist as the answer to all our problems. As fire never sleeps, So the journey of St. Peter Julian Eymond is not stagnated for sleep, but moves to seek the Lord in his celebration of the Eucharist and to live the prophetical life by serving the humanity. Today, we celebrate the feast of our founder throughout the world in a restricted manner. We thank God for availing this opportunity to us. As we are the friends of St. Peter Julian Eymond, who has accepted his way of seeking Jesus in the Eucharist, he invites us, each one of us, to be like him as the man on the move always, and to make the love of Jesus Christ in the Divine Eucharist as central in practice, that every thought, word, decision and action of ours is examined daily in the mirror of the Eucharist, so that we may live our life more enthusiastically and to make Eucharist lived in our service to one another. As Jesus was on the move, as Jacob was on the move, as St. Peter Julian was on the move, let us also be on the move to reach out one another during this crisis of corona epidemic through our sincere prayer before the sacrament for all those who are afflicted and affected, through our kind action of charity towards the needy at a place where we work, through being available to our community members and to others outside in a limited measure, and through constantly encouraging people through social media with positive presentation, and so on. Let us make our life as a gift of self, of our will, our personalities and our affection to God and to Christ in the Eucharist. Let us not leave a day pass without walking with the Lord, walking with our fellow human being and walking with the nature, like Jesus on the way to Emmaus, assuring our support to one another. Then we become men on fire and men on the way as true disciples and worthy apostles of the Eucharist.